Okay, guys, welcome back to the New Attitude 2024 Part 2. I should have put, I got a new attitude. But like I said, like, I did not really feel like editing this video. I love this hairstyle. Even though my part, look, I do this hairstyle all the time. My parts are never like perfect. I don't understand. Like, y'all don't even know how bad it is. The parts, they're not. Yeah, but not the point. So this will be put out. I put it in on Tuesday, but I feel like I'm just gonna edit it right now while it's 8 o'clock, and probably just have it, what's it called? But like, you time it, I don't know, like, what's it called? Like, have it upload on its own, like, just schedule it. I'm gonna schedule it to upload on its own. That's what I'm gonna do. So, yeah. So, we'll post it like maybe tomorrow, maybe Thursday. We'll see. But like, tomorrow, cause I need to get these videos out. I got other videos to edit and put out. So, yeah. To make it put out the same night, who knows?
Being bothered by the internet, I mean, sometimes I do be bothered because some of y'all be annoying, and some of y'all really just negative, but I mean, I know some of y'all are just negative assholes, period, in general, but whatever. I'm gonna do a whole little series about that. It's, for example, I'm gonna make a YouTube video about what I seen about Misty Copeland saying that there aren't any brown or, you know, universal skin tone friendly ballet shoes. And in the comment, they're like, oh my god, she's complaining. There are universal ballet shields. There is a company that does it. If the top ballerina, she's at the highest level, I believe, of what a ballerina could be, and if she is saying there isn't none, whatever brand you're saying that's available must not be up to par. If the top ballerina is saying that, she's still, the top ballerina cannot find damn shoes for her to get toned. So your white ass comments about it is irrelevant. Like, speaking of that, let me drop down to one of these on here. No longer care about white people and coons. Y'all so concerned that white people be stealing our stuff. They stole people. White people stole human beings. And these are probably just stealing clothing, hair, dance move, culture, food. I don't care what they did. You surprised? I'm tired of it. I'm tired. I'm not going to have the argument about hair. I mean, I did make a whole YouTube video because a coon, this girl on TikTok, which, I mean, yeah, I think she's on TikTok and on YouTube. I mean, I don't know how the girl got 4C hair, but she got a big-ass coon. For real. And how they don't understand that we're not, it's not really gatekeeper hairstyle. It's that boss braids came from a culture, and you try to act like it didn't come from that culture. And the fact that these white people want to have our culture, but they want to kill us and beat on us and throw us in jail. Like, I don't think coons white people understand that. It'd be totally different if y'all were nice and good people as a whole, but because you guys are more slave owners, because you guys want, voted for and allowed Jim Crow laws, because you guys are still killing black people freely on the streets. I mean, you guys still go to jail for it if y'all don't mind killing them. I mean, some police officers, we have to, like, what's it called? Process for police officers to get put in jail for killing black people. You guys are surprised they have an issue guys wearing a fucking hairstyle? That's the problem. It's that simple. And then y'all be friends with the coons. And speaking of coons, like the black people that ain't really hip, white people know that you're a coon. That's why they're friends with you. They know you were shitting on your own people. They know that for a fact. And speaking of that, so YTP Henson, she's talking about how black women do not get paid in the industry. We all knew this. Old news. Know it. Why does Doc Man is like, why she feel like she should get paid more but only know her from Baby Boy? Who only knows her from that? Who only knows her from that? Are you serious? You ain't serious. You gotta be serious. So like, what? Only know her from that? Economy. Hidden Figures. I could do bad all by myself. Empire. I feel like she was in Sister Sister. Which I'm surprised because she said that Baby Boy was her first movie, but I swear I've seen her in older movies than Baby Boy. So I'm like, is she really? Because I feel like Baby Boy is not her first project. Like, it cannot be her first project. It just can't be. It can't be because I feel like, I'm not crazy, I feel like I've seen her, like, let me see. She's been in movies before Baby Boy. or TV Shows Before Baby Boy. What Men Want. No, that's not the one I like about her. That's not the one I like. That's not the one I like. Proud Mary. I need to rewatch that movie, but she had a son. Ooh, what the? Oh, the camera just falling. Let's see. What's that? Proud Mary. I need to rewatch that. I mean, I seen it when it first came out, but I never rewatched it. She was in a movie I like. What is it called? Not Thinking Like a Man. No. What is Thinking Like a Man? No, it's like the one where she could hear all men's thoughts. Okay, it doesn't say anything about her being a sister, but. Smart Guy. That's what I think. I see her as Smart Guy because I rewatched it on Disney Plus. She was a smart guy. Or like, you know, they had the like pop up roles. No Good Deed. I remember that. Like, does he not watch movies about black people? Because what the fuck are you talking about? Oh no, I'm a baby boy. Bye bye. Yeah, I think it's Woman One I'm thinking about. Okay, then of course a white woman came. A white woman said she's a screenwriter, but she's not in Hollywood. She was like, well, I'm a screenwriter. Why do I feel like I should get paid like other people in Hollywood? You're not even in Hollywood. Like, of course you're not going to pay like that. Because whatever screenwriters you're writing is not making it to Hollywood. So you're damn straight you're not going to make Hollywood money because you're not in Hollywood. Hollywood. Thank you, Hollywood. You're not there. So it was kind of just irrelevant and ignorant. On top of that, it was a movie with Brad Pitt. I want to say, or some other way, dude. I don't know. I'm so sorry. I'm dead. How white people are not knowing black people names. I don't like the white people. I don't know a lot of them. I know, right? But I think it was Brad Pitt. I'm assuming. And he got paid $10 million. She asked to be paid $500,000. And she ended up selling for $150,000. And the fact that people were still judging her, he got paid $10 million. The budget for the movie was $150 million. She asked $500,000 and got paid $150,000. You're still judging her? Oh yeah, F the internet, F these white people, and F these coons. Because what? And as long as we let these coons and white people make decisions for us, we will always be at the bottom, we will always be low. Because when we ask for more, we get judged for asking more, we deserve more. She deserves to be paid $150,000. I don't care if she went after Brad Pitt. It's somebody pissing and Brad Pitt. I don't see the difference. Maybe because I'm black and I don't know much about it. I know Brad Pitt is Brad Pitt, but Taraji P. Henson is Taraji P. Henson. Period. Alright? Period. Oh, these coons, white people. Okay, man. Listen, if you're a coon, just being a white people business. I don't care if you're black or not. You're a coon being white people business. Don't bring yourself to your color people business all of a sudden. Don't do that. Just stay your white ass over there. Even though you're brown skin. Do whatever with my hair. I mean, I know I just said I would cry if I like do something to it, but I see the internet like judging, not really judging, but like saying that when black women like, you know, firing their hair has something to do with being white. I don't know why white women think that. Don't know why black women think that. Having straight hair or flat ironing your hair is more so like convenience, and some of it does look better with flat iron hair. Not whiter, not whiter. Like it just be the style. That's literally it. I had nothing more to say. I wearing wigs. Like, sometimes, girl, like, you think I'm gonna do this all the time? Do you? When you're washing, detangling it? I don't really have to detangle my hair. I really don't. But, you know, brush it out and then add product? Like, no. I would put it flat on. Wrap it and take the wrap off. Put on a wig. Brush a wig. I'm done. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not that big of a deal. It's still bleaching my hair. I'm gonna stop bleaching my hair. I'm gonna try my best to stop bleaching my hair. No, I'm getting closer to God for sure. Just read my Bible. I'm going to start doing that. I'm actually going to try. And yeah. Because obviously you can see I need it. Because some of y'all be, ugh. Yeah. I'm loving my body no matter what stage it's in. Basically what I just said about not comparing myself to other people. I've gained weight. 10 pounds. Still got a fat ass and a semi-flat stomach. So. And I've been watching videos. And then you see some bad girls with the big old thighs, but the big old butt, and a chubby stomach, and still be confident, it'd be like they fine as hell. So I'm like, you know what? Yeah, my stomach a little bit chubbier than normal, but like, it ain't like it's huge. It is chubbier than normal. So I was like, you know what? This is the body I have at 20. I might have the same body at 21. I might not. Maybe smaller. Might have my old body back. But It happened. You get people gain weight. That's okay. It's life. Your body changes. Now you want to die again. Great. Hold on. Let me rush through this. Doing whatever I want to be happy. I don't know what that really means. Like, I play soccer. I mean, I have a soccer coach. And is it, I just like to go sometimes. I don't really like to drive. So, like, I can't really say I like to go. But I go to have something to do. And I go because I do want to get better at soccer. I mean, I have my motivation goes up and down. Like, a part of me like, oh my God, I want to be a pro soccer player. I get the training sometimes. Or I get the coaching sometimes. Not coaching, but going to my coach and be like, yeah, going pro, nah. Some of the days I'm like, going pro, yay. It's still kind of hard to be motivated. To do something that seems so far away. And then I'm always like, are you sure you're going to go? Like, are you sure we're going pro? I'm spending all this money on coaching and training. Are you sure? And I'm just like, yeah. And a part of me was just like, I don't know, might as well try. I mean, I'm sorry that it costs money, but I mean, not like I'm in high school anymore or I could just spend time with a coach that the school pays for. They coach you, but they don't like coach you in the sense of one-on-one, making sure every peg is better. You know, it's not the same. I'm drinking and I need to eat. I haven't eaten all day. Wait, did I eat today? I ate very little today, so I need to finish this to go eat. I actually pay my instruments because I've been doing that. I literally paid to get my instruments tuned, or did my mom pay? You know, I had a job there, so I probably did pay. I paid to get the tune, and didn't touch it. I know, bad. Really bad. But you tune your instrument, and your brain goes like this. Which means your grades could go like this. Because your brain is doing, I'm working. So your grades when you're studying go like that. Studying and focusing more because of, not just studying and focusing more. Not even going into detail. I better be able to see, ain't no way. That's how I'm right now. Ain't no way. I'm gonna love you. Those are not the right notes. But you get the point. Ain't no way by Rita Franklin. By May 2024, my singing teacher said March. Yeah. I hope so. I mean, by March, I should be able to, like, if I practice and do what I'm supposed to do. My opinion is, I don't believe the internet's a job. I don't know how to explain it. I mean, I could say YouTube, maybe. But I don't see how TikTok and Instagram is, like, for real. I feel like people didn't do it because it pays the bills. I mean, okay, let me say that. I don't think it's a career. I don't think we just got, because I just naming stuff, careers like that. I mean, something is a career, something is a job. I see it as a job, sure. But like, I don't feel like it's anything that's like, oh my gosh, what's the word? Of any substance, I guess. But that's my opinion. I don't believe in it. I feel like if I ever was to be a content creator or something, I would cop it at like a certain age. Oh, like, you know what? I'm 30 years old. Like, what am I doing here? Making videos about what to eat for lunch. Like, I need a real job, or I need a career. But that doesn't matter. But everybody's different. Whatever. Being my emotions and love it, which goes into the same thing I say about men who can't do that. Same thing about women who can't do that. I mean, we are human beings. We all do have emotions. Now, I didn't say I'm not emotional person, which is true. But when I feel that type of way, if I'm upset, then I'm upset. If I'm mad, then I'm mad. If I'm angry, then I'm angry. If I'm happy, then I'm happy. If I don't know how my emotions are, I don't know. But whatever it is, I'm going to sit in it until I can figure it out, or I'm going to just let it pass. Because that's why I don't understand among people who are able to be emotional or are sensitive or are comfortable with their emotions is let them just be passive. Don't try to have these pep talks. Be like, you shouldn't be angry about that. Like, why are you hurt by that? Or like, why are you sad? Let people be. Like, let them be until they aren't that anymore. I don't really drink it. It's pineapple juice, but I feel like when you have foods with, or drinks with sugar in it and you don't eat, it don't feel good. And just like I just said, not something for a man that has manhood trauma, yeah. Even if it's like been decades, you'd be like, Madeline, we know men been taught the same thing for decades. I don't give a damn. I don't care their grandpa, their dad, their grandpa, uncle are all the same. I don't care if every man from the 1960s to 2023 all have the same traumas. I'm not dealing with it. I'd rather be single than what? Unhappy. Alright. Okay, let me say a lot. I'd rather be single than unhappy. Okay? Okay. Thank you. So I feel like I've been talking loud this whole time, and I said that really low. Try to be more positive, but still understand that some things are just bad. Like, I'm more optimistic, and I'm more, like, realistic. Like, when something's effed up, it's effed up. When something's sad, something's sad. When something's going wrong, something's going wrong. I'm not the type of person to go to, like, try to find it all my energy. Like, the smallest point of positive and stuff. Like, some things are just really bad. But if I can find a positive something, I will try. I finished writing my books. My TV shows. And write more songs. Now, when I say this, a part of me really wants to say not finish the book, but have my book published and have my TV show or TV shows. I need to pick one, right? I mean, you can write both. I mean, if you like, I don't know. Finalize. I don't know what the word. I guess you mean ready to pitch or like ready to like find a group of people to record. You know, really on Facebook, I asked people like, what's a good production company to pitch my TV show to? The guy was like, you don't need to pitch your TV show to nobody. Just get a group of people on campus and rent out the equipment. And I understood him for sure. I'm not judging him. I'm very thankful for that advice. But the other part of me is like, I asked a production company for a very specific reason. And the reason was due to, I would much rather like have a contract where I paid the company wherever whatever I make on a TV show for the equipment, instead of having to use my own money for the equipment, if that makes sense. So that was really what I was going for. I knew I was doing to ask that question. But like I said, I was rude to him. I said, oh, thank you. I mean, I don't know. I feel like the way he did come out. But you know how some people talk, not some men. I think that they just talk so opinionated, I guess. Or they just talk so much like I'm Mr. Right. I don't have the exact screenshot for it, but I just remember me feeling kind of off by the way he had said what he said. But yeah. I still don't think that makes much sense, because I literally said I was constantly in the video and in the comment, in the post, and you're telling me to go rent out equipment. I can barely eat on campus, sir. I'll find a production company. I'm going to pray to God and help figure it out. I still don't think that's the right way. Unless it's going to be recorded on this camera or on this iPhone. Deadass. That's probably how it's going to have to be recorded. Caring about celebs, negative or positive, like specifically when it comes to like Halle Bailey, that her mom did not make her Haley for specific reasons. Cause Haley and Bailey, that'd be hard to say. The girl name was Holly, but not Holly, like Halle. You know, whatever. And DDG, I mean, like people were judging her, black woman, talking down on her because apparently she's pregnant and married, and they were like, oh, AJ, look at her, knock her up right when she got successful, right? She's in Ariel. Like, how dare he do that? You ignorant mother cluckers. Yes, I come to some black woman that said that on Instagram. Ignorant. This woman got a major role, a significant role, that for decades, for childhoods on, is going to know a black Disney princess that is Ariel. One. Two, she's pregnant. That's great. Three, she's married. This woman has a career, a marriage, and a child on the way. A dream for most women. Okay, yeah, I said most, not all, but for some of y'all that got a sick of your ass, that's a dream for some women. To be married, have a child, and have the career you want. And that just not did I forget? Her song Angel is, what's it called when people vote for you to get something? Has been nominated, I think, for a, it's not a Grammy, it can't be a Tony, because that's acting. But okay, I'm gonna say, I think it might have been a Grammy. I think she got nominated for a Grammy for a single song. This happened within a year, maybe in 2 years. You guys are judging her, you assholes. Go Haley. I mean, like, that was me. I've been on cloud nine. I got my man, I got my child, and I have my career. I can't ask God for more. I can't. I couldn't. Cause what else I'm asked for? What else could you need? Or even talk about Beyonce. Now this is supposed to be for the end of the video. I don't care if you don't like her. You owe her 900,000, but talking down on her, I feel like a lot of black people do not understand that God, the Lord up above, can make this. It's not a wish, it's not the devil. God can do this for black people, God can do this for women. Because if it was Taylor Swift, I don't hear jack about no Taylor Swift. I don't hear jack about the Jonas Brothers. I don't know who else is waiting famous. I don't know. I'm sorry. Like I just said, I know white people. I don't know white people like that. I don't know who's above Beyonce. Taylor Swift ain't above Beyonce. She cool and all, but honey, but hunches, she ain't above Beyonce. We have heard her songs. We have heard the vocal ability. We have seen the dancing. Talented girl. She ain't Beyonce. She's not. But she all that. I can say, like Taylor Swift, I don't not go down the girl. She that girl. But it's just Beyonce. My point is, y'all say jack about Taylor Swift. They say a whole lot about her. Black people, not even white people. Black people. I mean, of course, white people too come and they be racist and shit. But you know what I'm saying? I don't understand it. Don't agree with it. And even the stuff about Jay-Z and like this, that random black ladies talk about. Niggas have an industry. Now, I do feel like some people are horrible in the industry, but I do feel like you give a person to talk, they would say shit about any and everybody. And also, Michelle Williams is a godly woman. You cannot convince me on this planet or on this earth that Michelle Williams would continue to be friends with a person like Beyonce. Beyonce was all and everything that she was saying. She wouldn't. And I don't believe that her band members would work for her for a certain amount of time and believe that she's a witch or whatever. And when they get fired, they want to say shit about her. Like, you were that strong with your faith and that strong with your morals, you would just quit on your own. Which is the way to get fired to talk shit about her. It's not adding up to me. Unless you had a contract, but I mean, like, your morals are that strong, you just get out the contract, right? Right. But this don't care no more. I know people are ignorant. I know people are going to say whatever. And you can't even trust everybody that said they're in the industry. I mean, some people are like genuine in the industry and they do have their truth. But they are these, but you know. And yeah, some videos are coming out is, or I don't know, maybe a podcast or a video. Is people might stop saying or stop believing that their experiences are like one-on-one. I feel like things we go through now in 2023 or maybe going, have been going on like the past 2 decades have gone on centuries ago, you know, or like ages ago. Like, you say men are all trash, your granny said it. Oh, all the new generation is so dumb, your granny said that as well. Like, stop it. The shit we go through is not that new. Like, everybody must share their opinion. They had radio calls in back then. People could use to get on TV back in the day and share their opinions. People get on the radio and share their opinions. It's not that new. People have podcasts. People burn books. YouTube and other forms of social media was out back then. If people want to share their opinion, they did and they could easily. It's still the same. Not more so for me though. Got like dang, we gotta hear everything people feel and say. My mom was like, so did we. It's because they have it differently, but we all that deal with people talking around the one in their mouth. And then I realized, because I'm not like super old school, but like, you know, I watched enough older stuff to understand that back then. It might look similar, or like it might appear as it's oversaturated random people's opinion, because it is. I mean, come on now, how many TikTok people or Instagram people have we known that has gotten famous or social media famous off of really saying weird stuff on a social media until one go viral? Right. So it's still a lot. Y'all just say, oh, a few. No, it's weird of courtesy people. I mean, I don't follow them, but like, you know, you click on the page, oh, they're kind of funny, you realize that, oh my gosh, she's one of them. She just wakes up in the morning, tries to think something, she goes to the grocery store, it should happen at the grocery store, they just want to tell it to Facebook or Instagram or TikTok, it's like, goddamn. So, you know, that's, I feel like it's always been something that's been going on. It's not that new. And neither really is, even though I said I don't feel like social media is a big deal, and I mean, I don't, as a job, as a career, that's not also new, because there are people on TV that their job was to literally show you products and have you pay. And have you, like, buying a column. None of the things that we are seeing is new. It just now going on here. And speaking of what I want to say, I'm saving that video, that magazine for last. Because, like, I've been saying this for a lot because I hate the way modern things are going. I cannot stand having everything on your phone. I mean, like, everything was on your phone. My mama, her car thingy, on her phone. I'm like, you don't give me a key fob. And leave it at that. You don't give me a settings in the car itself to do X, Y, and Z. I'm not doing using everything from my phone. It's annoying. But I forgot where we went. Like, we went to like 2 stores. And they were like, oh yeah, you gotta like check like your balance, like your points on an app. It's like, dang, back in the day, you just had a boop, 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 boop. And it sent to your email. It showed up on the worker screen. It showed you on the screen at the place of business that you're getting points at where your points were. But where your points were. But now you gotta get an app. This happened twice in a row today. I'm just like, listen, I'm young and I'm tired. You have to meet at Starbucks. Like, you know, you come off there, you know, you gotta like add your card to your app. I'm just like, oh my gosh. Lady, I don't care about the app. Take the gift card. She was so sweet and so happy and so like cute. I don't feel that way about her. But just by having apps for every little thing is insanity. I didn't even like it in high school because now my storage will be wasted by having apps for everything to now. Yes, I know I'm college, I need to save money, but I'm tired of it. Like, I don't need a second phone just for all that. Just due to the storage it takes up. Just because of that. And like I said, basically with magazines as well. Like, you know, we actually get to read. Like, you didn't, like, it wasn't like you just, like, went on Facebook or Instagram. You scroll and found out things you like about celebrity. You read it. I don't know, I don't get copyrighted. But, like, you read it. It's just paper magazine. You used to read about it. That's what one thing is. I do love God for sure. Obviously, and believe in God. But I can't come to terms with hating or fighting issues with people that are gay, bisexual. Also, because I don't care. Transgender, I don't care. I just can't understand how it's so much hate. And someone dearly loving somebody. Now, I have seen some lesbians, but they, no, 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 they be yelling at those pastors or whatever. And I mean, that's just a personal thing. And they be like, well, and then our other lesbians are like, you know what? I know I'm a lesbian, but I still love God. You know, like, I think it's a personal prayer type of thing. But I just can't. I can't. I don't care how long I sit in the church, how many times I read the Bible. I just can't see an issue with somebody just loving somebody. I can't do it. It's hard for me. I'm not really going to press the issue to try anyways. Beyonce is that woman though. Like, she had older women being inspired by her. Much older. Like, y'all hate on her. I'm tired of y'all, for sure. But one white woman I am happy to see come up is Billie Eilish. That girl can sing. Say what? And this other girl that's with an M. I don't know any of her music, but I seen her Instagram. I think it's like Matea. I don't know, but she's straight up gorgeous. Got pretty eyes, nice ball structure, like nice nose, gorgeous eyes. I did say that, gorgeous eyes, and she can sing. She can sing for sure. I can see her coming up, but like, yeah, that's all I had to say. For this, so that's my new attitude. Is not really nothing negative, I swear, but just kind of like coming onto my own, like whatever. When I'm beeping me in the car, like, what you gonna do? Come out the car? You can come move me out this street. What you gonna do? Nothing. I'm gonna do what I gotta do to get home safely. At that, so pipe down with your horn, or would you ride my behind? Don't have to be a grandmother, but like I said, it's not my house. My dad didn't ask for the front to be decorated. It's not gonna be decorated. He has the money to pay for it to be decorated. You know what I mean? Like I said, I don't know why somebody would decorate a home for with no children living here. But that doesn't mean that I don't really care if you decorate. I feel like I would decorate my inside my house when I have my own house. And I don't think she understands the thing of like having like your own and living in your parents' home is not the same at a certain age. Like, when you're a child, that's all you know. But when you get older, you move out, you go to college, you start to realize like what having your own really means and what it's like to be in with your parents' house. I'll be telling my mom, then my dad and my mom be like, this is your house. I'm like, this is y'all's house. And like, this is your house. I'm like, this is y'all's house. So, yeah. How do we ever make you happy? Like, I don't know. I might end up being a pro soccer player. You're not. Might end up being a doctor. Might end up being a sports psychologist. Might be an actress. Might be a model. Might be a producer. Might be a singer. Probably would do it all. I mean, there's a lot of life in here, and I'm not saying I'm gonna do everything for a very long time, but you just, God take the wheel. I don't know. I mean, if I wasn't gonna play pro soccer, you know, I could easily probably just be like, being in a few magazines, you know, whatever, Sports Illustrated. Just gonna have cameos in movies and in commercials. Gotta get out the league. I can move into modeling and acting a little bit easier. And while I play this locker, whenever I go to the studio, do my thing, pull out a few songs. What if it's me, somebody else? What if it's Grammys? Who knows? Look at that. In this industry, where I'm having two jobs at once, not a problem. I believe in doing that. That just me. Some people just like, pick one. I'm like, hey, life is short. It's always long. It's kind of long, but it's always kind of short. Also, I'm saying always, but also kind of short as well. So we gotta like kind of like balance the two jobs or the two careers. When I say I'm gonna do the two careers like the same week, maybe same month, maybe every 2 months. But you know, balance. I know that, but I don't want to sit on my behind. Like, could I be modeling right now after soccer training, after soccer camp, after the season's over? I could be modeling when the season's over. That's what I'm gonna go do. I'm not saying I'm gonna have booked like 3 fashion shows a month or a week. Not what I said. Maybe 2 a month. Not a lot. You don't know. So, something like that. But, yeah. I don't know where 2024 Madeline's going to be in and at. Like I said, I'm not paying money for me to right now to go pro in soccer. And it's up or down emotions with that. But I'm not going to tell her that. Because I do genuinely love the sport. But, it's like, I don't think I'm done with the sport. I don't think I'm done. So, and, you know, whenever I get money, I pay her $2,000 back. I don't know how much it gonna add up to by 2024. Probably will be that much by then. I'll give you her money back. But what money? I don't know where the money come from. But God know. Cause I'm praying. And one thing is, I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I had to find a way by 30 years old to not need a roommate to live in an apartment. Because I'm a little bit scared to be in my 30s and not well off in life. To some extent. I need to have my own apartment, my own car. A furnished home, apartment or furnished house, condo, townhouse, a furnished one, and a car. With a car note I can afford or no car notes by 30. That's my, because I mean, I'm not to be really disrespectful, but by some 30-year-olds I've seen on the internet and just in general, I'm like, I'm so scared to need a roommate or to need to live at home because I don't have the financial to do it on my own. That genuinely scares me. So I gotta figure it out. I got 9 years to figure it out. And baby, I'm gonna figure it out. For sure. If I'm not married. If I'm married, I'm still figuring it out. But I mean, I ain't marrying no man that I can't have a house and a car. I just told you I wasn't gonna marry into that. And I'm definitely like older men. So I might be 28. He might be 32. And I'm okay with that. Alright, I'm totally done talking. My throat is dry. I was talking to accent for a little bit. I don't know where the accent came from because I don't have one. I don't have accent at all. My throat is dry and I'm hungry. I didn't eat today. I mean, I ate today, but I didn't really like eat a lot. So, they're talking. I'm editing this video tonight because I had some coffee earlier today. So, I'm going to be awake for sure. And yeah. I'm going to be over there until like 12 a.m. though, but yeah. Bye. Thanks for watching. And I hope it has been in focus the whole time. Because I took out my glasses. And I can't see. I can't see, actually. So, yeah.